love how you dance to rumba. But take some advice, paisano, learn how to mambo. If you're gonna be a square, you ain't gonna go nowhere. Hey, mambo, mambo Italiano. Hey, mambo, mambo Italiano. Go, go, Joe. Shake it like a Giovanna. Hello, kiss a digi. You get happy in the pizza when you mambo Italiano.
Dominic Little Dom Cataldo was born in 1936 on Essex Street in Brooklyn. He moved to the Ozone Park area by the 1960s and later relocated a bit further east to Valley Stream in Nassau County. He was a longtime associate who eventually became an inducted soldier in the Colombo family. Dominic had a brother named Joseph who was also an associate of this family and served under Dom. Dominic was 5 feet 7 inches tall, 150-pound muscular, compact, sharp and nice-looking man with a quick wit and quick hands. He had the potential for a fiery temper, but was loyal to his friends, both in and out of the mob. He was very well liked by his friends, not so much by his enemies. Little Dom made the rounds pretty good in his day, bouncing around New York, Long Island, and even South Florida monthly, looking for narcotics and scores. He was known as a heist guy or trickster, involved in hijackings, burglaries, and armed robberies, and also was an enforcer. He was known to have done ample work in his day. Cataldo owned a piece of several bars and nightclubs over the years. The lounge at the Kennedy Inn Hotel near JFK Airport was one. He also owned the Villaggio Italia restaurant on Rockaway Avenue on the south shore of Long Island, of which he was proud. But primarily, Little Dom was a hoodlum through and through. And he loved it. Think Jimmy Cagney style. Nobody fucked with Dom. He was a highly respected member who traveled in high circles. He was an intimate of many of the Colombo hierarchy, as can be evidenced by his inclusion in the 1984 Colombo family indictment. He was active in most of the typical rackets, including gambling, loan sharking, labor rackets, and extortion. Big time extortion. He loved shaking suckers down, but he was really into truck hijacking and planned big money heists. He also got into narcotics trafficking later in life, mostly cocaine, from South Florida to the New York City area. It is said he would set up and rob drug dealer shipments of cocaine and marijuana. He is alleged to have killed several drug dealers, burying them in the Florida swamps where alligators would eat them, thus disposing of evidence. Recognized as a very loyal and capable soldier, Dom was a force to be reckoned with. Aligned with the Persico faction, he did their bidding unfailingly. In the early 1970s, future informant Salvatore Crazy Sal Polizzi stated that he started out serving under Dom Cataldo as part of Cataldo's crew in the East New York and Ozone Park areas. Polizzi's uncle Anthony was originally associated with the Sonny Franzese crew. He was even indicted on bank robbery charges that eventually got Sonny 50 years. He was also tied to the Ernie Ruppolo murder in that it allegedly took place at Polizzi's Aqueduct Motor Inn, a charge that Sonny was eventually tried for and acquitted of. In 1981, Cataldo was convicted of possession and sale of guns with silencers to an undercover agent. He received 8 years in jail. In 1984, he was one of 11 top Colombo hoods, basically the whole hierarchy, charged in a huge 53-count RICO indictment. They were charged with extortion, usury, bribery, major thefts, robberies, gambling, narcotics, labor rackets, and more. Charged along with Cataldo was Carmine Persico, Jerry Lang, Dominic Montemarano, Anthony Scarpati, Jackie D. Ross, Frank Melli, Ralph Scopo Sr., who was the official of the Cement Workers Union, Thomas DiBella, and Vito Pitta, who was a top union official for Locals 106, Restaurant Workers Union. They were all held without bail as dangerous to the community after being arrested. After an explosive trial, all were convicted and received long prison terms. Dom got 14 years. Cataldo had been represented by attorney Michael Coro during the trial, a close friend. Maybe too close. Prosecutors would later indict Coro as a mob associate. This trial was a long and very interesting case study on mob control over many industries. Some of the unions claimed to be under the dominion of the Colombo family included Cement and Concrete Workers Union Local 6A, Manhattan, District Council of Cement and Concrete Workers, Queens, Hotel, Restaurant and Club Employees and Bartenders Union, Local 6 Manhattan, Hotel Employees and Restaurant Employees Union, Local 100 Manhattan, the New York Hotel and Motel Trades Council Manhattan, Teamsters Union Local 707 Queens, and Teamsters Union Local 617 Jersey City, New Jersey. Observers often say other New York families control all the unions, whether it be Genovese, Gambino, or Lucchese. But this 1984 indictment clearly showed that the Colombos controlled many varied unions, and this was just a small piece of their labor union domination in varied industries. It was said that you could not pour concrete in New York City without the approval of the Colombo family. Both the construction and restaurant nightclub industries were affected by them. Little Dom's many criminal associates over the years included Donnie Shack's Montemarano, who at one point was possibly his capo, Little Allie Persico, Alphonse Big Funzy Terracone, Tommy O'Sara, John Johnny Irish Matera, Tom Farisi, Anthony Tony Pop Trent Acosta, Fat Andy Reggiano, and Nicholas Botta. Cataldo's arrest record was hard to fully access, but it included assault, robbery, possession of guns, obstruction of justice, bribery and conspiracy, racketeering, extortion, narcotics trafficking, and more. In the early 1980s, a Queens judge named William Brennan was bribed by Cataldo and other Colombo hoods who got their criminal cases either reduced or thrown out. They utilized Anthony Bruno, who ran the lounge at the Pan American Motor Lodge on Queens Boulevard in Queens, as a conduit, since Bruno was a close friend of Brennan. This went on for years, until the scheme was exposed, by a rat of course, and multiple indictments came down. Bruno, always known as a weasel, turned rat and testified against the judge and many others. This is also the case where veteran Colombo bookmaker Nicky Botta also turned informant. While in federal prison serving his sentence from his 1986 conviction in the Colombo family trial, Little Dom got cancer and died on August 22, 1990. He was only 54 years old. Little Dom Cataldo was a true hoodlum and devout mafioso who lived every day as if it were his last, with laughter, breaking balls, and whose every waking minute was dedicated to thieving and scheming, which he quite simply loved. And considering he died so very young, perhaps he was on to something. Thank you for watching. We hope you enjoyed this episode of Mob Fireside Chat, presented by Button Guys of the New York Mafia. Let us know your thoughts in the comments below. Be sure to like and subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss our next installment. You can also visit us at thenewyorkmafia.com, where you can read many more true tales of the underworld, and join us for conversation on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Until next time.